We came across e-Yantra lab, which was set up in our college. So I'm from Brava University, Bangalore, and I'm from a mechanical background, right? I didn't have any knowledge on electronics department. Yeah, one of my professor, he introduced me to Dr. Veena K.N. She's the in charge of e-Yantra lab for Brava University. We went there at 6 p.m. in the evening, and she was working with a small Firebird robot. And there was a map laid out in the floor, and she was working alone. She was working, and all lights were off. We were like literally surprised. PhD holder is sitting on the floor. She's working on a robot. So if she has so much dedication, how much should we have? Because I need something. So that incident sparked me, and on that exact day, we spent around I guess 11 or 12 in the night. And there was some issues in that particular Firebird, like electronics was fine, but the thing is the wheels were not properly aligned. There was some kind of rubber sticking onto the wheels. She was not figuring out that out, but we three as a mechanical guys, we went there, we figured out that stuff, and she was impressed with that. And she told, okay, so why you, then only she asked, why did you come here? Okay. And yeah, we told, we had some kind of concept, and this e-Yantra had a IIT tag to it. So our three members goal was, we need to step into an IIT campus. How? Through this e-Yantra lab. So that was the initial intention of getting into that particular lab. So what we did, we spent time with her, and we spoke like, this is the concept what we have. And she told about the ideas competition, then we applied for it. And the concept was using robots or using an automated system to clean the manual sewer pipes. So we spoke to one of the guy who actually goes and cleans the manhole. So what he told is, you give me some kind of automatic thing where something goes inside the middle of the pipe and clears and removes some of the blockages there and comes back. You don't go inside the vertical pipe and get the blockage which is there in the vertical pipe. I can do it easily. The three guys, we were carrying all this stuff in hand. And we were managing all the TT and everything, because he was telling that this electronics and all is there. You need to get some certification, all these things. You need to put it in goods compartment and everything. We need to clear all these things. We cleared all these obstacles. Then we took it to IIT Bombay. Then the mind was in such a way that we thought we need to dump the prototype there only, and we should run off. That was the mindset. So I think most of you had similar kind of mindset. Okay. You need to cross all these things. That's what I'm trying to say. So what our college chairman did is, he told, okay, you have done something. You develop the same concept for a real-time scenario. We'll fund you. Okay. Then three guys can't take the entire load. Yeah. So seeing us, our juniors joined us. In third year, we formed a team. It's a team of 23 guys. 23 guys, how they came? They just came because we took up that challenge, we went there and we did something and we got back. And the main thing is, we got money from the college. See, getting money from the college is not a small thing. Yeah. Because, yeah, seriously, getting money from college, and big money, I'm telling you, it's around 10.5 lakhs. So whenever we step into the lab, the environment will change. Yeah. So it was like, you do whatever you want, you brainstorm, you do everything, like anything is possible in that lab. We used to spend day and night, literally day and night in that lab. We used to sleep in that lab only. I had my own bench to sleep. Managing a team of 23 guys is not a easy challenge. And all were from different years of engineering. Like one were from first year, second year, third year, final year. Yeah. You take this thing, you do it in a real-time scenario and come back to me. We did the same, it didn't work. It didn't move at all. And whatever we imagined in the real-time scenario, or whatever the dimensions what we had thought of, when we opened the actual manual, the entire thing was different. So according to us, what is a manual? A vertical thing is there, vertical pipe. Then again on the bed, there is a horizontal pipe. And again the same thing continues. When you opened the actual manual, there was a vertical pipe. And it was not having a bottom. Fine. It was going fully depth. And the pipe was lying mid-air. And the pipe was very much slant. Yeah. So this was the problem. We saw that we couldn't even put the prototype machine inside the pipe. Not even, it didn't even went inside the pipe. and we tried to recreate the same in our lab. It didn't work. We consulted some industry guys. We took all their inputs in mind. So this was the control system. So whatever the messy wires what you saw earlier was replaced by this. And each and everything is done by students. I'm telling you, students. Nothing works first time. In this manual testing, no, the lab testing was very fine. We took it to the manual. We spent around 2.5 months next to the manual. I'm telling you, next to the manual, literally next to the manual. I used to put my hands inside and do all the things. I used to correct all the things. So what I'm telling you is, nothing works according to what you have planned. And you need to put a lot of dedication and work into that particular thing, whatever you are passionate about. Yeah. Without backup plan, you should not do anything. Yeah. You need to take calculated risk. Not just a risk, calculated risk you need to take. I'm not telling you blindly go and start a startup, then everything falls into place. No. You need to have a plan in mind. If this fails, what is your backup? But the core thing was, I needed to start a startup of my own, which was a very good, very big player in terms of automation. That was my back-end goal. And we started the startup. Our college gave free space. The e-Yantra lab, whatever you see there, they told you make use of the entire lab. They even gave us a working space, like a co-working space kind of office seat in the incubation center. Yeah. You need to learn how to speak to an external investor or an external person. You need to figure out that mentality, right? That way of speaking. So whenever you want to start a company or you want to do anything across, you need proper mentors in place. And mentors not only for technical, emotional. Yeah. If nothing works out, you need someone to cry on. Okay. You need some kind of shoulder to cry on. Yeah. That kind of support also you need. Yeah. So you need proper mentors. And through that Boeing, I got 2 mentors. And also, I searched a lot, and one of my mentors is Dr. Kaviarya, and also from industry, as well as from marketing side, we got all mentors in place. We pitched to many, many investors to get the money in place, and nothing happened. Yeah. Why? I was pitching to the wrong guys. I was participating all the events, from normal pitching to all the high-end events, I was pitching it across. From Startup India and Startup Karnataka, they are like a portal where you can, as a startup, you can log in and you can attend the events, you can apply for events and do all the things. I had applied, went through the entire process. Then when I pitched in the regional levels, then I got to know what is my technology. So what is my product, where my product is going to be utilized. So till that time, I was not knowing, like I had no idea. I was going to all the manual maintenance guys. I was telling, can you buy this? And they were totally rejecting it. I had no idea where to go and like, what is my technology? So everyone will think my idea is this. If I say that idea to someone external, they're going to copy it. They're going to do it across. It doesn't work like that. And when you tell your product or tell your idea or tell your solution to any number of people, you get many critics. You get opinions. That opinions matters a lot. Okay. One of the opinion what I got is, instead of going to a direct manual maintenance people, go through a government guy, government agency, then the approach will be much more efficient. For the manual sewer pipe cleaning, we approached one of the government agency. They were impressed, and we are in we are having an MOU with them, and they're going to take it forward. Yeah. So opinion matters a lot, and expose yourself. Yeah. Expose your solution, expose your technology. You will get much more ideas. You can refine on that. Main thing is, don't get discouraged by anyone. Okay, take their opinions, take their critics, decide on your own, take calculated risk. That is the most important. I want to thank the e-Yantra team, the Dr. Kaviarya, and the college team who provided me a platform to just share my experience. Thank you, guys.